Good evening. An emotional James Heard has vowed to clear his name in the wake of allegations he was injected with a banned drug. Shell-shocked by the latest controversy, the Essendon hierarchy is sticking with the besieged coach, but warned of sackings if anyone at the club is guilty of wrongdoing. Tony Jones has today's developments.
Just when the dust seemed to have settled, Windy Hill was hit by a cyclone and swept up in it James Heard, accused of taking a banned drug.
Look, obviously, they're very upsetting claims. I just can't wait to get in and talk to Asad and the AFL. And once I've got in and talked to Asad and the AFL, I can't wait to clear my name. Thank you.
The allegations against Heard have been made by his former sports scientist, Stephen Dank. He claims Heard was injected with the fat-burning drug hexarelin, banned by WADA in 2004. The Bombers are again in the firing line.
Oh, well, look, they are at this stage accusations, so, you know, there's wait for the investigation to continue, and I'm sure that once that's done, then they'll be a little bit more clearer with the whole situation.
As Heard oversaw a short training session, rumours swirled that he'd been stood down, Chairman David Evans setting the record straight.
James Heard is a person of great respect at this club and indeed the football community. And the board will not be making decisions about the next steps until the processes of the review and the investigation take their course.
But the chairman left no doubt that if need be, heads will roll.
If anyone at our club has breached the duty of care, the board will act.
Reputations, careers, indeed the future of the club now rest with the outcome of Essendon's independent review, headed up by former Telstra chief Ziggy Switkowski. As for when that will be completed, no deadline has been set. So, in the meantime, Heard is putting on the bravest of fronts.
James, how's today impacting you?
Good. It's all good.
You all right?
Yep.
Dank has also claimed that Heard used another drug which helps in tanning, sleeping and libido. While it was generally accepted that coaches were immune to bans for drug use, AFL boss Andrew Demetriou moved to clarify that today. In short, they will be punted.
If any coach or official puts the duty of care of their players at risk, then they will be held accountable.
Timely, the Bombers were able to escape Melbourne on a trip west to take on Fremantle tomorrow night. They spent a precious 4 hours in the air, but the task of clearing the air will take considerably longer. Tony Jones, Nine News.